JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for June the 15th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar was found lower or unchanged against most of the other major currencies this morning. It was higher only versus the Japanese yen. The greenback lost some ground against the euro, the kiwi and the loonie, while it traded unchanged versus the pound, the Swiss franc and the Aussie. The relative strength of the commodity-linked kiwi and loonie combined with the weakness in the safe haven yen suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that, yes, indeed, most major EU and US indices closed in positive waters, with the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq hitting fresh record highs. The only exceptions were Germany's DAX and Wall Street's Dow Jones, which slid somewhat. That said, appetite was more on the mixed side today in Asia. Although Japan's Nikkei 225 and South Korea's KEO SPI traded higher, China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng edged south. In our view, this means that following last week's inflation data from the US, investors have been more comfortable increasing their risk exposure, even with the Fed decision drawing closer. Remember that despite the sharp acceleration in the CPIs, the details of the report revealed that both both the headline and core rates rallied to 5% and 3.8% respectively, further above the Fed's objective of 2%. The details of the report revealed that there were hefty contributions to that from short-term increases in airline ticket prices and used cars, which supports the fact that the latest inflation spike may indeed be due to transitory factors. Having said that, though, ahead of the data, several policymakers have expressed their desire to discuss quantitative easing tapering at one of their upcoming gatherings. Thus, although we don't expect officials to rush into taking action now, it would be interesting to see whether there will be a discussion around the matter, and if so, whether we will get any hints of a potential desired pace of withdrawal. A fast pace may suggest that Fed officials do not see the surge in inflation as transitory as they did in the past, and may hurt equities. At the same time, the US dollar and other safe havens could come under some buying interest. On the other hand, any discussion suggesting that the time for scaling back monetary policy has not come yet, or anything pointing to a very slow pace of tightening, may encourage market participants to increase their risk exposure a bit more. Speaking about central banks, today during the Asian session, the RBA released the minutes from this month's meeting, where policymakers stood pat and reiterated that at the July meeting they will consider further bond purchases. In the minutes, it was revealed that their decision will depend upon the board's goals for employment and inflation, as well as the likely effect of different options on the overall financial conditions. With inflation standing at 1.1% year over year, well below the lower end of the bank's target range of 2-3%, Aussie traders may have stayed convinced that there are decent chances for policymakers to add to their program, and that's why they pushed the Aussie slightly lower. In any case, the next focal point may be the employment report for May due to be released on Thursday. Now, a review of a stronger than expected report may be needed for market participants to discount the smaller probability for a quantitative easing extension. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK employment report for April. The unemployment rate ticked down to 4.7% as expected, while the employment change revealed that the economy added less than forecast jobs in the 3 months to April. Average weekly earnings, both including and excluding bonuses, accelerated by more than expected. The pound barely reacted to the report, perhaps as GBP traders are still waiting for tomorrow's CPIs for May and Friday's retail sales for the month. Later, from the US, we get the retail sales and PPIs for May, as well as the New York Empire State Manufacturing Index for June. The headline PPI is expected to have ticked up to 6.3% from 6.2%, while the core rate is forecast to have jumped to 4.8% from 4.1%. Headline sales are anticipated to have fallen 0.8% month over month after stagnating in April, but core sales are expected to have rebounded 0.4% month over month after sliding 0.8%. The New York index is expected to have declined slightly to 22 from 24.30. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.